No! Darn it. Is that going through now?
Shit, I've been rambling this whole time and,
I feel like an idiot.
Ah, there we go. Alright, we're fixed. Thank you so much, Ducky. I feel like a jackass. So anyway, let me reintroduce myself, seeing you heard none of that, guys. Let me just start the stream over, okay? Alright. Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Matt DMS here. Welcome back to my channel. Jesus Christ. And today, I'm going to be mastering a beat tape produced by Ragz. Ragz is a member of the podcastage Decressy community. And he's been asking me to work on his project for the last 2 months now, but I've been so caught up with freaking work that I just haven't had the time. I just took my sleeping medications. I'm going to see if I can get this finished before I fall asleep. And I got some Coke Zero here. It's been a while since I've had some of this stuff. So, you know, this is a special occasion. I feel like, you know, going a little bit ham tonight. Let's see if we can get this done. Anyway, so what I've done is I opened up Isotope Ozone. Now, this is a plugin, which I think is one of the best plugins for mastering audio. I mean, it's got everything you want. It's got EQ, it's got maximizer, it's got a maximizer, stereo imaging, and all of that fun stuff. Now, the thing that I think is interesting about these beats that Ragz has made is that they're relatively simple. So really, all I have to do is just bring out the clarity without destroying the overall detail of the mix. But I don't want to make it too harsh. That's the thing. When you're dealing with really simple stuff like this, you don't really need to do much to it. Let me just turn that down for you guys and turn my speakers off. Jesus Christ. Okay, so when we're dealing with relatively, you know, yeah, it's pretty out there stuff. So what we want to do is we want to bring out the maximum sound possible. So what I'm going to do is, let me just run this through let's see what we can do here. I usually try a Popmaster basic run, and usually that gives me what I want for like anything. So let's see how that sounds. I don't know how that sounds, but maybe I could bring up the volume just a tad. I guess what I can do first is normalize this. Let's give this a try. Hey, Ducky, let me put you on the screen here. Hey, buddy. We'll just leave Ducky there. He can, you know. Oh, never mind. Okay. No, there goes that. Okay, anyway. What we're going to do is we need to work on this. What we could do is actually normalize this first. So let's run a normalizer through this. Oh, gee. Okay. Never mind then. Okay. Let me just try. What can I do? Seeing this is let's try a hip hop master. Let's see how this goes. The strange thing about this is that it's not actually peaking, so what we want to do is add a little bit of maximizer. I may add about 147. Usually that would be enough to add, so let's give it a shot. I can't believe I started this stream without my mic. I feel like an idiot. The professional audio engineer. Yeah, right. Now, I don't want to add too much of that, so let's add an exciter. Dynamics can go up. Try an imager as well. Usually that works wonders. Alright, let's see how this sounds in the full mix. Alright, I think there might be a little bit too much here. Let me just check see how we're going here. Alright, we got 24-bit going through, so, give me a second, guys. Let me try a Tube Master. Actually, this might work a lot better. You see what that's doing? That's actually, you can add that. Alright, so let me, okay, let's go back to the Pop Master. I like the way that sounded better. So let's add that. That's with it turned off. That's with it enabled. Off. Enabled. So that brings out a lot more of synths. So that's what you want. You want the audio to have more thickness. So let's see if this peaks. If it doesn't peak, I can just do a gain boost in after the ozone. I do not know why it's not peaking. That's quite strange, but we can just do a digital boost here. No big deal. But I'd say maybe 1 dB a boost should be more than enough. Let's see if it peaks. Okay, that's weird. There's actually like, on the right channel, it's actually not even peaking. So, I think I may have to do some imaging. So what I'm going to do is, let me see. I can't do an imager with the basic settings. Let me try Pop Master. Let's see what happens when I turn up dynamic. Let's see if that does anything. That just compresses everything to hell. All right, I don't want that. I'm quite happy with the stock Pop Master settings. What I might do is just increase both channels so that they're both where they need to be, and both peaking. That way, it's a more stable production. Let's try 6 dB. This may introduce some artifacts, but I'm not 100% sure if it will. Let me just turn it down so I don't rape your ears. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be too bad. That's looking pretty good. I like that. The one channel is still struggling to get up there, but if you listen to this, this definitely sounds better than what we had before. Let me switch in between. See, that was the boring dry sound. That is a much better sound. I'm sorry, but that is amazing. I just improved that, like, dramatically. So that's one song in the can for your boy Ragz, I reckon. Let me see what we can do with this. Oh, there's an abrupt pop at the end here. I can probably fix that with a simple quick fade out. It's kind of awkward when that happens in my recordings. I try to avoid it, but sometimes it's unavoidable. So what we're going to do is we're going to attuneate this part here. Just give me a second. Let me do a quick fade out here. It should eliminate the pop. Oh no, hang on. Does it even need to be there? It might be a bleed. I guess we could just get rid of that. How can I end this with a... What I'm going to do here... I'll tell you what, I'm actually going to modify the beat. I know I shouldn't be doing this, but I got a feeling I can make this part of the beat sound amazing. Give me a second. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to load a track effects. I'm going to go to Tau Dub, which is one of my favorite reverb plugins. Like, I swear by this. I've been using this bad boy for the past... How long have I been using this? I have no idea. Like, literally since 2012. So, it has been a while. It's been a while, so let me just explain to you why I absolutely swear by this plugin. Give me a second. You see what I mean? That is how you end a beat. That is how you do it. It's I love this plugin. Like, it just makes everything just pop. Like, there's something about it. So, in order to fix that really awkward ending, I just made it, like, just awesome. Wow. Okay, so, let's listen to that. Now, that is freaking amazing. Like, seriously. I might make that a little bit less awkward with the pop at the end there. Give me a second.
Burp.
I might have to try a manual drag. There we go. There we go. Now we're talking. And we can just render this as is. I'm quite happy with this. This sounds quite phenomenal. So let's save. Should I just save this as... what's the name of this song? Where is the... there we go. This is the entire tape here, by the way, guys. So that's TNK. So we'll just save this as TNK so I can remember what I've done here, and I may be able to apply it to my own stuff if I feel like it. But right now I'm quite happy with this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt... to give me a second. All right, so let's put this back up to where it should be. Let's just save and let's do a render. So I'm going to render this. Let's just render this to the desktop. I'll move all these files later. So let's make sure it's 16-bit so that we can crush down that noise floor. Keep it low, I should say. So let's render. Actually, before we do this, let me just check something with the intro. Oh no, that's quite a clean intro there. Okay, well, we'll just leave that. I don't need to do a quick fade in there to fix an awkward pop or click. We can just keep that. So we are good. Let's render this as a WAV file, 16-bit PCM. 512 PT. Yep, we're all good. So let's do it. And booyah. Okay, it still looks weird in waveform, but that's all peaking where it should be. So, yeah. Let me just have another listen just to make sure I might have screwed something up. Give me a second. I think I could fix this easily. Give me a second. Let me just screw it. Let me just try boosting another 2 dB. Let's give that a shot. God damn, that really raped my ears there. Sorry, guys. Right, let's try 10. I really want to get that other channel peaking as well. Shit. Okay, I think this is about where it should be. It's generally peaking. Alright, I don't want to push it anymore, otherwise we're going to completely ruin the signal. I don't want that to happen, but this is completely mastered now. Like, it's really loud. Let me just lower the volume and listen to it to make sure there's no distortion. Sounds pretty clean. I think there may be some slight distortion there. I don't know if I'm able to fix that. I could attempt to stereo image it and maybe get more sound on this side, but I don't know if it's worth it. It may make things sound weird, so I don't know. But generally, that is peaking, albeit like very occasionally. So I don't want to ruin a good thing going here. So let me see what's going on here. Yeah, there's a lot of cuts. There's a lot of cuts going on here. if it hits 9, it's not really, it's usually not a big deal if it goes to 9. It's usually worrying if I go to 12. If I'm cutting 12 dB off the signal because it's overdriving and whatnot, that's going to cause a lot of distortion. It's going to sound really weird. So I think I may have found the sweet spot. There is some slight clipping and distortion, but the sound is definitely a lot more richer than what we had. So I believe the fact that we have a better sound kind of is worth that sacrifice in signal. So yeah, I think we are good. There is maybe one thing I can do to reduce that bass distortion. I could add some slight EQ, maybe give it some scoop. Let's see if this works. Let me just see what's going on in the EQ section. All right, that's giving it a little bit of a. Can I see what's going on here? Give me a second, guys. Okay. Right, so what that's doing is giving it a very big roll-off in the 80 hertz area. Maybe that could give me a little bit of room with the kick, because the kick seems to be the thing causing the distortion. If I can get rid of some of that harshness, I may be able to reduce the distortion I'm getting. So let's give it a shot. Alright, I am happy with that. That sounds fantastic. That is brilliant. Okay, I'm good with this. This is good. This is ready to go. That's the best I can do for it. I could have done maybe more, but I'm in a bit of a rush here, so let's get this done. Alright, that's one song down. Beautiful. Just to make sure there's no awkward popping at the end, I will insert a envelope for volume. Just so I can do a nice fade out here at the end. So let's just do that now right here. Through this bar here. We'll start it at this bar. That way I can get a nice clean fade out to about, let's count bars here. Oh, that's a bit of an abrupt ending. Alright, right here, right about here. I reckon I can do a nice fade out right here. There we go, on this bar here. Let me just snap to the, I don't actually have the BPM set for this track, so I'm kind of just doing a, it's at 160 BPM, so yeah, we'll just snap it here. It's no big deal if it's not on time. So let's, what should I do? Let me change the pattern of the fade out to something else. Give me a second. How do I do that? I want it to be a sharp fade. Here we go. Yep, just do it. Just do a really quick fade. How did I do it again? I forget. My mouse is playing up tonight. Alright, so, hey Ducky, you been at work? Yeah, me too. I only just got home at like 6 PM, and I've spent the last 2 hours trying to, fix. Alright, let's just try, Okay, this looks about good here. I'm okay with this. What am I doing? Fast start, fast end, huh? I'll just do a linear fade here. I don't really care about it. Yeah, we'll just do that. It's no big deal. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Give me a second. Yeah, we'll just go Lydia. Yeah, that's cool. There we go. Right about there. All right, I want the song to end right about here. There we go. All right, so let's just render this. This is finished. This is done. Save. Okay, I can walk away from this now. I'm happy with it. Let me just check the volume. Yep, it's all good. Okay, let's render. It's one track in the can. There we go. It seems to be peaking a little bit better now, although the right channel is quite really loud there. But hey, if you want the best sound possible and you want a really epic sound, then this is what you're going to go for. Unless it's not what you're going for. I don't know. I haven't really asked him what kind of sound he wanted. I'm kind of just trying to make things sound as epic as possible right now. So that's turning a really simple thing going... Basically, this thing just went from... Let me turn it down so it doesn't rip your ears. It went from this... to this. So, definitely an improvement. I could imagine some rapper or something getting on this and spitting some crazy shit. Maybe. I don't know. It's up to you guys. Pretty good stuff. What are you saying, Ducky? I'm between jobs now? Seriously? Wow, that's nuts, dude. I don't know. I would not be able to handle that. I seriously would not be able to handle that. I have a hard enough time working with projects as is. And then my, you know, my day job. And then it's like, wow. I don't even know, man. Anyway, this is this done. I might be able to maybe reduce some maximizing that I've done, though I have not really added that much. What if I reduced maybe just a little bit? Let's see what that does. Actually, I kind of dig this. Let me put this at like, let me put this about 50. Okay, so it's still peaking here, like, not like, but it's nowhere near as rapey as it was before. All right, you know what? I'm cool with this. Okay, we'll just, so I turned it, okay, so I laid down, I laid off the maximizer. Now I can use more of a flat EQ now. I'm not sure I like this. It kind of sounds boring. Although it does sound good. I'm not going to lie. I kind of like that. But I liked it when I had about this much EQ. About 119. Yeah, it's kind of good. I like that. Let me just check the... Okay, so this is what happened to the EQ when I did that. See, it adds kind of a flat... It kind of does a... Yeah, it does a nice shift like this. It kind of enhances the clarity a little bit and gives it a little bit of... Yeah. So that's definitely interesting. I guess we'll just keep it like this. Just have a little bit of clarity, so that's all good. Okay, so, yeah, that's that. We're good. Looks pretty flat here, so I don't know, it might be sound just a little bit too boring. But hey, you know, I think... This would be possible if you're a producer and you wanted a nice hype track for someone to spit some shit over. I reckon this would be good. Yeah, that's definitely got that pop, and it's not so harsh now. So I'm good to just render this as is, and we can start on the next track. I'm 100% satisfied now. That sounds amazing. There we go. Okay. And just remember, Ragz can always fix this up again if he wants, if he's not happy, so it's fine. But what I've done is just made it a lot more compressed, basically, and just it just sounds a lot more commercial. But let's just go straight to the next song. Let me save this project as something else. The next track, which is Down In It, I suppose. So let's rename this Down With It and save as On Mixed Metaphors. Okay. Let's dump that in here. And we might even be able to use the same settings. I don't know, but we can give it a try. Oh, this looks pretty good, actually. Oh, it's a bit, okay. This is definitely a lot simpler sounding, and it seems to have... I don't have to add that much gain to it. I can probably dial it back a little bit. Just so that there's not much distortion. This is a lot better mixed, Ragz. Good job with this track. You've got a lot more stable mixing going on here. I like this. I can even dial it that back to 6. Sounds fantastic. Let's try 5, actually. Yeah, it's definitely peaking now. Let's just dial it up one more. I can see it not failing to peak there for a bit. Okay, I'm happy with this. I'm freaking happy with this. This sounds fantastic. Like, I don't even have to do anything. Like, I can just use the same settings. Just for the sake of consistency. But what's this part here? What's going on here? Oh, that's some beautiful bass right there. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm loving that. That sounds great. That sounds great. I really like that. That is freaking amazing. So anyway, I guess we are good to... Let me see what I can do here. Okay. We might as well move our fade out points over here so I can do a nice clean fade out of the song. Let's have a listen. Wow, that's a really clean ending there. Let me listen to that again. Wow, that's cool. That's a really nice, sharp, clean ending. Maybe I can make that a little bit more easier. Just do a nice quick fade out like that. There we go. So now it's a little bit less... And we can read it. We'll just end it right here. There we go. Do a nice sharp 2-bar ending here. Cool. Looks good. Right, so let's just drag this over here. There we go. Drag this up. Give me a second. All right, so that's good to render. I'm quite happy with that. That was a lot easier than the previous track. Mainly because it's actually got some decent production, decent dynamics going on here. So let's save this as 2. There we go. Render it. Same settings. Brilliant. Wow, it's one huge block, isn't it? I know it kind of looks weird on here, but it definitely sounds good. So don't worry too much about the waveform. That's a nice, big, blocky waveform. It's beautiful. I love it. Okay, so... It's definitely really high-mastered. A lot of people have compared me to Rick Rubin when it comes to mastering because I am a huge loudness war guy. So I you know, I like working with stuff like this, like being able to make it a lot louder and be able to get more, you know, power into the audio. But I, at the same time, I'm a fan of dry music. I don't mind simply produced stuff that sounds really quiet. As a matter of fact, I think it might be easier to work with, mainly because of the fact that when you're recording dry vocals, you're doing really simple, minimalistic stuff. It's a lot easier to mix, and it's a lot easier on the ears, so that you can have your mics dialed in to the point where there's no, you can't hear any noise floor, everything's nice and clean. I actually really like that, but the beats that Ragz has sent me here seem to tell me that I need to push this into people's faces, because it just screams. It screams compression and maximization, and that's what I've done. But hey, you know, most of the stuff I work with is usually pretty well, like, compressed and whatnot already. This is the first time I've ever really worked with something that's as dry as this from someone that I'm not familiar with. I have worked with some stuff that's dry as this, but usually all I do is just boost it digitally. I don't even add, like, anything to it, but for this, you see how small the waveforms are here. I had to do a fair bit, and because I did a lot of boosting, all of this other stuff ended up getting, like, boom, blown into a huge puffball. So that's pretty much what happens. Anyway, let's try the third song now. Let's give this a go. Let's save a new project, and we'll give it a whirl. We'll get through this. Okie dokie. So we've got a new project. Let's just dump this bad boy in here. KNT. Remix. Oh, wow. It's got some pretty good stuff going on already. I don't think I even have to do much. Let me just listen to this softly. Oh boy, okay, so I don't have to do anything. Oh my god, okay, there is a lot of low end there. Okay, I think I have to take some of that out. I can do that easily. I will just do I'll just move the EQ bar sideways a little bit, like this. Let me just close this so that you can see what I'm doing here. Okay, do a nice low cut here. Actually, give me a second. Wait, what am I doing? Oh, let me go back. Okay, that's what I had before, wasn't it? Oh, yep. I just had a little bit of... Yep, okay, so we'll go high pass here. Let me see. Low pass, high pass, that's what we... We could try a flat... high pass, like, yes, that should cut a lot of the low end, I believe. That will cut a lot of the low end, and I need that to go away. Let's listen to this again. Because there is a lot of thump here. We need to get rid of that. Maybe I could do a complete cut to 80 hertz here. Let's see if that does anything. Okay, now there's a lot of distortion going on here. So what this tells me is that I may have to do some EQ here as well to bring out some mids. I need mids. Okay, I don't know what to tell you about this track, guys. I think this is quite unsalvageable. Because I just did a low cut, and it still sounds like balls, so, let me see what I can at least attempt here. Let me just turn off this. Wait, there is some serious low end going on there. Okay, I kind of dig this. I actually really dig this. It sounds pretty sweet. I think this might do. I still want to keep those mids. I need those mids, but I did roll off a couple of mids there, so I don't know. I'm hearing a lot of crazy distortion going on here. Let's see. Let me just try. Alright, it's peaking again at 8. This definitely sounds pretty crazy, and I'm quite happy with that. I wouldn't say this is one of your best beats here, Ragz, or remixes, I should say. It's quite problematic, but hey, you know, this is I did something to it. Whether or not that was good or bad, that's up to you, but hey, we got something done. Cool. Oh, I like that ending there. Well, I don't think I need to really do a fade out there. I'm quite happy with that. We'll just leave it like that. All right. Yeah. Pretty good, Ragz. I mean, you clearly got a knack for production. I just don't think it's necessary to go overboard with this much EQ. It's quite all that low end that you added to the beat. Sorry, bumped the mic. Basically, I had to take out again because it was like really, really bad. There was a lot of rumbling and it was terrible. So what I did is I had to remove a lot of it. In doing that, I remove detail from the entire recording, and that's an issue. But what I did was try to at least smooth things out a little bit the best I could and turn down the clarity. Sorry, so that I could at least prevent the out of control frequencies from tearing everyone's eardrums apart. But hey, you know, live and learn. But yep, that's all good to go now. So let's render this. All right. Oops, I have to name it the third one. My bad. KNT re-remix. There we go. Oh, wait. Oh, I forgot to turn the volume up. My bad, guys. I'm a professional audio engineer. Anyway, whatever. Still got that same shit going on with this part not peaking. It's weird. I don't know. It's whatever. All right, let's go to the next song. We'll save this. I might save as with the other beat. So use this one as a template because I believe this is good settings here. If we get another beat like this, I may use this. We'll give it a shot. All right, so let's save this as beat number 4, Duck and Groove. Is that what it is? Shout out to Angry Ducky, I guess. Let's save this as a new project. Alright, so we'll just give that a shot. Alright, that's cool. I like this. I'm okay with this. Alright, so let's drag this into the project. Okay, we've got another mastered. This has already been mastered by the looks of it. That's pretty solid. Let me see hear how this sounds without any processing. Tell you the truth, man, I don't think I even have to do anything to this. But let's just see what I can do anyway, I guess. Don't want to add too much compression. I don't even need to do this, I don't think. Oh, wait a minute! This is Ducky's theme song! This is Ducky's theme song! Isn't it? Yes!
Oh, okay. Okay, so, let's have a look here.
Sup, Mind of Hughes? How you doing, buddy? That's some crazy shit you're saying in the chat there. Thanks, thanks for that. I appreciate it. What the fuck? Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, let's just, yeah. So this is Angry Ducky's theme song for his streams, I believe. So what we're going to listen to it without any processing, and then we're going to listen to it with some processing. Let's give this a shot. I mean, you know, this sounds pretty damn good as is. I mean, that just sounds banging. Do I even need to do anything at all? I don't know. Look, it's even peaking properly where it should be. I'm pretty okay. I think maybe it could go up 1 dB, maybe. Like that. I think that's all I need to do. Okay, I don't have to touch this. This has obviously been mixed really well. So, you know, let me just work on just fixing the end up a little bit. Let's see what we can do here. Alright, you wish, Tony. Alright, here we go. Well, that's a bit awkward. What's going on there? Give me a second, guys. Alright, let's see what we're doing here. It's kind of, yeah, that's kind of a weird, it does have a pop here, so what I'll do is I'll just do a quick fade out so that it's not so jarring when it ends like that. Okay. Oh, it's still pretty poppy. Give me a second. There we go. That's much better. That's much cleaner. There we go. And we can end right here, so let's just drag this over. This is a great beat, by the way. I always hear this during Ducky's streams, and it's like perfect. It's the perfect duck anthem. Quack, quack. So I don't need to do a fade out effect. I don't think so. Let's just get rid of this shit. your boy Husey trying to be edgy in the chat as usual. I love it. No, I love it. It's entertaining to watch. So what was I doing again? Oh yeah, delete points. Delete point. I don't need to do a fade out here. So let's just clean this up so that I don't accidentally change anything. Actually, just to be on the safe side, I'll just bypass the fade out so that it doesn't accidentally screw anything up. Alright, so let's render this. Make sure I turn the volume back up to normal. That would help, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it? Oh my god. What do we got? Yep, we're at zero. We're good. Alright, so let's just save this as dock and groove. Like this, 16-bit PCM, we're good. There we go. Okay, so that's good to go. Let's work on something else now. So what else do we have? Okay, mobile attack. Interesting. Interesting. Alright, so let's go... Let's just open this project again. And we'll just save as, just in case. This is another one of these ones. Alright, so let's go to mobile attack. Phase 1. Okie dokie. Alright, so... Let's drop this into the thing and see what we can work with here. Alrighty. Okay, so this is another one of those things. Let's just have a listen to it in low volume. Okay, there's a lot of bass going on here. It's rabbit season. I love it. Okay, as I suspected, there's a lot going on here. There's a lot of bass. I don't know what to tell you guys. Should I EQ? Yeah, that seems to make it a little bit less... Are you rapey? maybe I should do another high-pass filter. Let's try that. Give me a second. Okay, that definitely fixes that. But it still sounds a little bit... Well, at least it's not peaking anymore. So I could give it a digital boost. Okay, let's start to sound a bit better now. Wait, what was that? What's going on here? Oh, I accidentally saved. That's the... Oh, Christ. Yeah, that's just part of the song. Give me a second. Let me get it out of here. Jesus. Please tell me I didn't leave that in the other track. I better go back and check, just in case. Oh, I did! Holy crap, I'm an idiot. Let me just re-render this. My bad, guys. Shit. I left this in duck and groove. That would have been a blasphemy if I would have left that shit in there. Give me a second. Christ almighty. Alright, let's just re-render duck and groove. Everything else is fine with this track. So, no problem. Yeah, it's mistakes like that that can really slap you in the face. It's like, what the fuck? Why? You know? So let's just re-render duck and groove. Alright. Yeah, that's one of those things that can really give you a headache, like when you fuck something like that up. Okay, so let's just see. Okay, I've taken the one out of here, so we're good. Alright, let's listen to this. Alright, so let's have a listen to this. Okay, so that's peaking relatively normally, where it should be. So I'm quite happy with that. So what I'm going to try to do now is... We could probably just leave this as is. I don't want to add too much gain to it. This is pretty damn good. I like this. So let's listen to the ending. That's a clean fade out. Okay, I won't even bother like with this thing. I can just disable this. Alright, we'll just end the track right here. Oops. Well, I'll just get it to just render the entire track. So let's turn it up. Yeah, did not have to do much to that. All I did was just do a slight low cut, and then I just boosted. So, you know, I got rid of a lot of that problematic bass, but I was still able to keep some level of clarity there. So that's pretty cool, I guess. Let's just... Oh, shit, what am I doing? Let's just entire project. There we go. Yes. Okay, that definitely, the waveform definitely looks a lot better now. What's next on the agenda? Alright, we'll just do another one of those. We'll just save as the second one again. Alright, so, easy mode. Let's go for it.
What's this? JK Rowling just announced that this YouTube channel is gay. She's also planning to give Matt the role of Dobby. Hacker alert, Matt's internet history contains searches for Lemon Party and butt plug purchases. Hardy ha ha. Alright, let's go to the sixth project. Alright. So let's just dump easy mode in here. Alright, so again, this looks pretty well mixed. Do I even need to do anything at all? We'll just have to give it a listen. Let me turn it down again. Oh god. I don't know what to think about this one. Let me see how this sounds normally. I mean, that's peaking normally. I guess I could give it a 1 dB boost. It's just like Duck and Groove. There's not much I need to do to it. So that saves me a headache. So another great beat here, Ragz. It starts out awkward, but you definitely nail it. Damn it, that same shit's there again. God, I don't want to have to fucking see that again. Alright. Alright, so this sounds pretty damn sweet. I don't know about that intro. Maybe I would add a slight fade. I can hear a bit of a pop there. That's cleaner. I love that. That's good. Alright, so let's go back here. Yeah, that's an awkward cutoff there. Let me just fix that and we're all good. Great, that's perfect. Couldn't have asked of a better mix there. Good job, Ragz. Good job. Really getting the hang of it now. I'm guessing the beats that you were producing, as the album progresses, you're getting better and better at producing, because this sounds as good as Duck and Groove, and so that's pretty cool. So let's just save this as easy mode, the hard way. Alright, here we go. Let's give this a shot, and we'll just render... Oh, I don't want to render a time selection. We'll just do the entire project. Alright, so let's just give this a shot. That's pretty cool. That way it only renders the waveform. So, yeah. It's good. Who would win a rap battle between Matt Dimas and Lil Tay? Does she even rap anymore? Let alone do anything on the internet? I'm curious. Like, what's her status? I feel sorry for the kid, man. Her parents, her mom and brother have fucking basically exploited her.
All right, so we'll just let that. Okay, let's render this as easy mode. Oh, I already did. Well, I'll just do it again just in case. There we go. That looks pretty sweet. I like that. If you didn't know, Ducky, Little Tay was that girl that's like that was like flaunting money and whatnot. It was kind of cringeworthy. Yeah, and just being like, "Yo, bitch, you broke ass bitches," blah blah blah, and she was like, I don't know, 8 years old or some shit. It's kind of crazy. LOL, Tay has done more for the hip hop culture than Tupac, Biggie, combined. Whatever you say, buddy. Okay, so let's go to the next track. Off the Hook. I'm letting you off the hook, Tony, for that ignorant statement there. Next time I won't be so, fuck it, I don't even care. Alright, so let's go to the, let's just save as this one. Fuck it. That way I don't have that problem when that little part always pops up. Fucking, let's see what we can do here. We'll say Project As. Alright, off the hook. There we go. Okay, so that's saved. Let's go and dump this bad boy in here. There we go. Again, another greatly mixed track. I really don't know why you wanted me to mix the majority of these, but hey, here we go. Oh, Jesus, sorry, guys. Didn't mean to do that. Okay, here we go. I mean, again, very nicely mixed. Like, it's even peaking. It's even peaking properly. So, you know, I don't have to do anything. Let's see if I can add slight compression. I might add slight compression. Let's give it a shot. Okay, that definitely makes it sound a little bit better. But then it does a little bit of a drop off. Let's just give it 1 dB boost. There we go. Sounds great. This is, sounds a lot like Duck and Groove. I love this. This sounds fantastic. Okay, let's check the intro. Ducky, Little Tay's rap can be found by googling Two Girls, One Cup. It's a... Really, dude? Come on. That's not funny. You're not funny. Here I am laughing because it's not funny. This measures his helpful review. Oh god, what is this?
What is this? I'm into duct taping your mom's face to my...
Oh, where the fuck do I find these people? Seriously. This won't surprise you guys, but he's from Florida. So, you know. Big shucker, right? Okay, let's go to track 7. Hey, that's a clean start. I like that. Let me just turn off the effects. Okay, that is actually a super clean intro. Alright, so let's go here and just have a look. Oh wait, I already, No, this is all good. No, I already mixed this. Did I already render it? I got distracted reading the chat. I forget what I was doing. I think we're good. Let me just render this. Oh yeah, I wanted to check the intro and outro. My bad. Oh, fuck. Sorry, guys. God damn it. Alright. No, I don't have to do anything to that either. That's fantastic. Okay, let's just render the entire project. Let's give it a shot. Oh, I already rendered it. Okay, that's good then. Oh, my bad. The fuck? I turned the volume down. There we go.
Don't worry, guys, I'm a professional audio engineer.
It's pretty sweet. So, yeah. That's that track done. So let's save as, I guess, whatever. Let's make a new song. Track 8. Pulled against... what? Nothing? Okay, well, it's just called Pulled Against. Okay, we'll just get rid of this. Alright, let's drag it in. Again, we've got another well-mixed song here. Oh, we've got some bass. We've got a lot of bass, actually. Maybe I can give it just a little bit of a boost. Let me check zero. Yeah, I could probably give it 2. Oh, let me turn the compression off first. Oh, God. Okay, adding that low pass definitely cleans that up. Yep, this sounds very gnarly. I like this a lot. Let me just check the fade out. Oh, that's not that clean. That's not the fadest intro I've heard. Let me just give it a quick fade. Okay, that's good. Donald Trump made an appearance in Two Girls, One Cup. He was the brown stuff. Oh. Matt, is your cousin still hot? You should hook me up with her. That is if you're not going to be jealous, of course. So let's fix this intro. Alright, that definitely cleans that up. Let's try the outro. Oh, what's going on there? That's kind of weird there. I think I might do a cut here and then just do a quick fade here. Okay, that's good to render now, I'd say. All right. So that's all done. That's the 8th track we've done now. On a roll. All right. So let's save as this one here. Let's see what we could do. Healer's Throne. Oh, fuck, sorry. Already mixed that, what am I doing? Alright. Okay. Let me see how this sounds with zero. Yeah, I could just keep just the way I could just keep the same mixing. Yeah, I'll just, you know what, I'll just keep the same settings I had. This beat sounds relatively similar to the previous ones, so I will just save and we'll just render this. Let me just listen to the beginning. That is a smooth intro, let's check the outro. Oh, that is awkward as hell. Yeah, let's just fix this up. There we go. Beautiful. Maybe a bit more aggressive. There we go. Definitely a lot more cleaner. Let's render as healer's throne room. Entire project. Render. Oh, yep. Yeah, I keep doing that. That looks very nice. Okay, that's 9 tracks down. I'm just gonna have a quick break. When I come back, I will complete the rest of the album. So I'll just put some music on in the background while I'm gone. I just need to fix up some stuff in the house, so I won't be too long. I'll just throw on some of my friend Soul 8's music while we're waiting. I'll just type an I'll be back message. Just need to do some stuff. Just give me, I don't know, maybe 5 minutes. Yeah, make that shits really big. There we go. Alright, I'll be back in a little bit. This is Earth to Mars. Whoa, sorry guys, Jesus Christ. This is Earth to Mars Expressway. What will it do to my brain? Pornography. I'll be back shortly.
In the room, white walls, white floor, white noise with a view. I saw others in bliss. Guards with the rings, they scrunch in a fist. So bright in the lab, I couldn't see the doc with the knife in his hand. They motioned me, they opened me, they poked in me. And nobody, forget who I am.
Proceed to the door and exist while you can.
I can't be me. They told me 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 I can't be me. I can't be me. I can't be me. I can't be me. I can't be me.
Give me a second, guys. Give me a second, guys. Fuck it, let me play another song.
Broken inside, your eyes close and you figure it out. but there's no way you can figure it out. Cause the second you get it, you're finished. And the second you get up, you forget it. So forget it, I won't be toying with it. Boy, if this is what I think it is, we may be straight ruin, and the ruins will be glistening with faux blood, our own blood, glint of a merciful sword. The winner will take our culture and then purge it from lore. Rewrite the pages of history, the world isn't yours. Take the pen and with the ink you can circle the score. Decay the youth, and when you think that you're worthy of more, reverse the denigration and you won't hurt anymore. Till I feed you with the truth that I got from a memo that my boss sent. And I swear he has no hidden agenda. He's not acting as a puppet for some secret sect, seeking havoc or stress, yet to count the reasons left to lie to you seems.
I'm back now, guys. Hey. Anyway, let's get back into this, shall we? All right, so we've just completed this track. Let me just see if I rendered it. Yep. Okay, so we're going to be working on track 10 now. Let me just check the chat. This is like that time my mom said she was going to be her. Now I haven't. What the fuck? Dude, you got problems. Anyway, let's, motherfucker, let's just save this as, and we'll bring out the 10th track. Just give me a quick moment. Where are we? Okay, so 10th track is Shattered. What is that? Shattered what? That's weird. Shattered glass? I've always said shattered gas, but it's shattered glass. I'm an idiot. Anyway. Save as, let's insert this song. We'll just check, have a gander at the mixing here and see what we're dealing with. Yeah, another well-mixed track, Ragz. Do not believe there's much I can do to this. Let me just have a listen, turn it down so I don't rape your ears. Okay, this is interesting. This is extremely bizarre. Okay, that removes a lot of the stuff you don't want. Yep, that sounds a lot less rapey. Let's give it a 1 dB boost. There we go. Okay, that's relatively good. Maybe 2. There we go. I'm quite happy with this. Like, it's another great beat, Ragz. I'm proud of you, buddy. Let's have a look here. We're almost done, actually. There is only about 13 songs, so, you know. I'm quite happy with this. I might as well just render this. The intro is clean. Let's check the outro. That is a bit awkward. We'll just do a nice fade here. Nice sharp one. There we go. And we will just render that as... Turn up the volume. Very cool. Alright, next up we have Tongue and Groove. Let's save project as Tongue and Groove. Dot Reaper project file, whatever the fuck that stands for. PP. I need TP for my bungalow. Anyway, let's grab in this bad boy. See what we're working with here. Okay, another well-mixed track. Looks great. Let's try this with 0. No rapey, damn it. Too much bass. Let's try 2 again. Okay, I like this. It sounds good. Let's just do a quick analysis. Oh, gee, that pop. Pretty painful. Let's get rid of that. Nice and clean. Here we go. We might just extend the beep slightly. Just so it's not so awkward when it ends. There we go. Okay, I'm happy with this. Render. On a roll today. 2 more tracks to go. Let's go. He said rapey, demonetized. Dude, I'm not even monetized. They revoked my partnership because I didn't have enough watch time. I didn't have enough hours. I just didn't meet the criteria anymore. It's stupid, but I understand why YouTube did it. Maybe I'm just saying that because I'm a huge shill. I don't know. Honestly, I don't agree with a lot of the stuff YouTube's been doing, but you know, I know it's a huge website and everything, so I try not to just make a big deal about what happens. It's just funnier just to laugh at it, just seeing all this craziness going on. I mean, I hate being negative. I was actually regretting making that Attack on Titan video because I fucking, I don't know, I just feel uncomfortable doing commentary videos like that. It just, you know, when you spit out negativity, you tend to get a lot of it back. And I don't really want that. I kind of just want to be, just be positive a lot, you know, and it's just weird why I want to do that, but whatever. That's just the way I am. There's a picture of a half-naked chick on the wall behind you? Huh? There is? Where? No, that's the freaking cover art of Slayer's Christ Illusion, you dope. you dang dope. Here I am, I'm talking like Banjo now. Milk and toast language there for you, so enjoy. Alright, so let's save us. The hell? RPP. Alright, so let's insert this track. Damn it, sorry guys. That's got a lot of compression to it already. I don't think I need to add any more. Like, there is a shit ton of compression there. The extra compression definitely brings it out a bit more. Let me just ease up on the compression a little bit. I kind of feel like that signal's really pumping hard, so I don't know. Alright, I really dig that. Alright, so let's check the beginning. Seems clean. Wow, that's a nice fade out there. I love that. Okay. I guess this is good to go too. So let's render. It saves me a lot of work. I'm not complaining if you've already compressed the hell out of some tracks. Matt, say A2 and the Underdog is a GOAT. That's debatable. Okay, so 12th track we have done. Now, we are on to the final project, and I can call it a night, I suppose. And the final project is... whatever this is. Let me just paste it. Tied Down to Runnin'. Alrighty, let's have a listen to what we have going on here. Oh boy, this is interesting. Hey, this is sweet. Do I even need to add anything at all? Pretty cool. Really nice, sleek ending there. Not sure that intro is clean. Let me just check. I think that should be good. I think we're good. Alright, so let's render as. Yeah, it's got a nice compression already. I just added maybe slightly more. So, you know, it's just really warm now sounding. So, I'm finished. The entire album's done. All that's left is me is to zip all these WAV files up and just send them to Ragz. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching me mess around on Reaper. I'll definitely be doing more of these streams in the future, so you guys can look forward to that. So yeah, thanks for watching the stream, and I will see you guys later. Take care.